Happy solstice greetings, everyone. Welcome to one of my altars, one of my many altars. So it is solstice time. It is time to celebrate endings and create new beginnings. So what I'm doing here is I'm running some incense across my altar, the spirit of the air, so that our prayers and thoughts and feelings can be heard and felt by the spirits that we call to. And now I will light the candles one by one. I had 3 rose candles here. And if you notice, I have my candle on my zodiac plate, which I think is really interesting for this time of year because we're approaching the end of the year. You know, we're approaching the end of the zodiac. So, it's nice to remember that or think about it. Here I'm lighting my 4th candle. And then we have the Baphomet, which is representative of the void of beginnings and endings. Solve et coagula. To gather and dissolve. And that's what is happening at this time of year. The energies have been gathered and now they are dissolving during the solstice. And down here, I have my pentagram to represent Satan, king of this earth, god of this world, god of the material world. It is his time for a season. It is his season for celebration. It is his time to be remembered and worshipped and known. So with that, we will do just a simple invocation to call upon the Saturnal energies of the solstice. We call upon you, Baphomet. Guide us through the darkness and the light. Bring us to a new birth in this new year. Help us to realize and manifest everything that we can be. We call to you, Lucifer, Lord of Light, Lord of the Air. Guide us with your wisdom and knowledge. Bring to us enlightenment in this new year. We call to Satan, king of this earth, god of this world. Bring to us all the material things that we desire. Help us to make the most of our life in the here and now. And we call to Lilith, queen of the heavens. Queen of the heavens, you bring us life, you bring us death. You help us to manifest the divine feminine. And with that, we are closing. I want to thank you for being here with my solstice ritual 2021 winter. Thank you. And hail Satan. Hey everyone. Welcome to the solstice 2021. I'm out here in my workspace tonight, outside in my workspace, because I really wanted to do this video and ritual outside, but where I'm at here in Florida, it is raining. It has been raining for 2 days, so everything is wet. So what I decided to do is just do everything here inside my workspace. You just saw the 2021 solstice ritual that I put together for everyone. just a simple ritual to focus your energies and think about this cycle of birth and death that occurs this time every year. Today is the longest, this is the longest night of the year, and that's something that I really appreciate because I'm a creature of the night. I really enjoy the nighttime. I feel like that's when I come alive. That's when a lot of my magic does its work, is at night. So I always enjoy when it's the longest night of the year. Also, I wanted to talk about in this video reasons why Satanists really like the solstice. Why is the solstice important for Satanists? And it seems like this year I noticed there's a lot more Satanists who are posting on their social media feeds, happy solstice, and they're focusing on the Saturnalia and all those aspects of magic that I just haven't really been seeing in the past couple of years. Like, this is, it just feels like it's something new that has really taken off in the past couple of years. So it's nice to recognize that Satanists do appreciate the equinoxes and the solstices. Not all of us do, of course, but for the ones that do, we see it as a time of year when the seasons change. And it's not just about the seasons, it's also about what they represent spiritually. And what the solstice, the winter solstice, represents spiritually is Satan, god of the earth, Saturnal energies, the energy of Saturn, which is a very grounded and earthy energy, the energy of Capricorn. You know, and I'm not saying that Satan is Capricorn or Satan is Saturn, but there are qualities of Saturn that you can find within Satan, that Satan is a very earthy creature, a creature of the earth, you know. And here we have Capricorn, Saturn, that is like the focal point of earth energies when it comes to magic. So it's always nice to associate Satan with a certain time of year. And everyone would think it would be Halloween, but you know, I always like to think about Hecate on Halloween, like how she's opening the gate during that time, because she is the gatekeeper. So she opens the gate during that time so that we can celebrate the darkness, the coming darkness. And this is our moment of darkness right here. It is the longest night of the year, so it's always wonderful to celebrate that. And also, this time of year reminds me of the Baphomet, just like what I have behind me and what I used in my ritual. The Baphomet is a source of creation, but also a source of destruction. So it's very symbolic for this time of year. And it, excuse me, it really makes sense for Satanists to, for those of us who are spiritual, I guess, or into like satanic witchcraft, to focus on the Baphomet and to use that power to create something new in the new year. So I hope everyone had a great solstice. I know I did. I was able to do a ritual even though it was kind of rainy and wet outside. And I want everyone to have a happy new year. I'm happy you're on this journey with me. I'm happy to be here with you. And I will look forward to maybe exploring another video when we have the spring equinox and we celebrate Lucifer. All right. Good night, everyone. Hail Satan.